What's up everyone, Morey Croson here, and I'm super excited about the video today because we're gonna go into how your body's actually set up for physiological success, whether you're trying to throw the ball further, jump higher, run faster, you know, lift higher weights, or run faster side to side, whatever the case may be, your body's actually set up through what's called muscle spindles and stretch reflexes, which we'll go more into in the video here. As always, if you like the information, go ahead and click the thumbs up down below, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and if you have any questions or comments or anything like that, leave those down below. We'll hop in the video right now. All right, so the first thing we're going to talk about is going to be stretch reflexes. And before we go too much into that, I want to go over what just a reflex is, which is essentially it's a unconscious response to an outside stimulus. So the greatest example of this would be when you're at the doctor's office and they go and they hit your knee and your knee automatically kind of kicks out and extends. So that would be a reflex. So now what a stretch reflex is when you have some type of stimulus such as pushing off when you're getting out of the blocks. And so we know that you're going to end up having to contract the muscles, but before they end up contracting, there's actually that stretch reflex. So at the end of the muscles, there is a response that goes back into your spinal cord to tell some of the muscles within the body to actually contract and shorten, and some of them to inhibit to allow that actual contraction to happen. And that is the stretch reflex. Meanwhile, we also have muscle spindles, which are small little receptors within the muscles, and there could be upwards of hundreds of these small little muscle receptors within a given muscle. And the job of these receptors or muscle spindles are to prevent the muscle from overstretching by actually contracting the muscle fibers. So the reason I wanted to make this video is because these stretch reflexes and muscle spindles play such an integral part in your success or failure as an athlete. So you ever get that great idea or have a great workout that you just know if you continue to do that workout or you continue with, you know, that idea, it will truly turn into something great. That would be an example of a stretch reflex. But then you also have your muscle spindles that put self-imposed limitations on you. Sometimes these can be good, sometimes these can be bad, but the concept of them is to prevent failures, setback, injuries, and to keep your body overall safe and comfortable. And this is where it gets really cool. Your brain must actually be taught what the amount of stretch reflex is needed, as well as the amount of activation needed in order to overcome any degree of resistance. So when there's an increase in what the body has to be able to overcome, there's also an increase in how much the muscle then stretches. And therefore, when the muscle stretches more, it activates more muscle spindles, which allows the muscle to be able to contract with more power and more force to give you more ability to overcome a resistance. But this is where the muscle spindle is really important, because if the muscle is stretched too far, that's what's going to cause an injury or a failure within a given life circumstance. And so, you know, as much as it's great to have those stretch reflexes, that ability to, you know, think outside the box, to be able to push yourself, you also need that muscle spindle to be able to keep the body healthy and keep it from, you know, over contracting. And so what does this all mean? It simply means you have to train your brain. You must perform more exercises. You must overcome more resistance. Your brain and your body are physiologically set up for success. They will adapt. They will change. They will be able to understand exactly what is the resistance that it has to overcome the more resistance that you give. So there's people that are not throwing the ball enough. You're not challenging your pecs enough, your shoulders enough, your back enough, your posture enough. You're not running enough. You're not starting enough. You're not overcoming enough resistance to be able to make your brain physiologically understand what it is that you are trying to overcome. So it doesn't know when you get to the situation of you throwing a, you know, 10 or 15 yard out across the field, exactly how much force it needs in that shoulder to be able to perform that. But if you're doing it more often, your body would adapt. The same thing with sprinting. Your body knows how to adapt to be able to run a 4.5, a 4.4, a 4.3. Other people are doing it. The reason that other people are doing it is not because they are genetically gifted or more gifted than you. While that could be the case, there could be more genetic gifts that somebody might have. That isn't the reason that that person is running 4.3 and you're not. The reason you're not running 4.3 or 4.4 or whatever is because you're not putting your body in a position where it's overcoming the amount of resistance needed to train itself to be able to get to that number to be able to achieve that actual goal. So you have the physiological capabilities to be successful in whatever performance you want to do, period, without a doubt. There's actual science to be able to prove it. You just have to be able to make the decision within yourself that you're going to make it happen and do it right now. Get after it, period, go.